Good afternoon. May grace and peace be ours in abundance this day as we celebrate the lives and the accomplishments of this graduating class. We come to this place on this day for many religious and spiritual traditions, and perhaps no religious tradition at all. We are all invited to share together, each in our own way, in a moment of reflection and joyous thanksgiving for the journey that these graduates have experienced. Almighty God, known by many names, heard in many voices, we invoke your presence with us today. Today we celebrate the accomplishments of those who receive these diplomas, of those who begin new chapters in their lives. We invoke your blessing upon them. There are those who have passed through Northwestern University and seldom looked left or right. There are those who have struggled and arrived here today battered and bruised. Make us each mindful, we pray, of all that they have accomplished. Let success mend self-esteem and give perspective to their achievement. Through your gracious spirit, we ask that you bless these graduates with patience as they explore new horizons. Bless them with humility in the face of success and abundance. Bless them with compassion for the poor, the sick, and the suffering. Bless them with generosity in the midst of the challenges that come. Bless them with gratitude for friends, mentors, and family who've supported them throughout this journey. And bless all of us, family, friends, faculty, mentors, and supporters, as we share in the joy of their accomplishments. Make us ever mindful of those whose shoulders we stand upon, as well as those whom we follow in their path. Even as we celebrate accomplishments and transitions, may we continue to seek guidance and wisdom. Hear our prayer. Amen.
Please be seated. First, relax. The hard part's over. Good afternoon, graduating class of 2019. Families, friends, faculty, students, staff, and honored guests. I'm Thomas Gibbons, Dean of the Northwestern University School of Professional Studies, and it's my great pleasure to welcome all of you here today. As a dean, this time of the year, where I'm pulled in a lot of different directions, attending many events to honor our students and alumni, I find myself shaking a lot of hands, eating a little too much food, and sometimes feeling a little overwhelmed by all the festivities as I'm also trying to get my final grades in for the term. Still, this is my favorite time of the year at the university. Certainly I enjoy this day because I see the pride in everyone's faces, the sense of accomplishment that you can literally feel in the air. This is also the time that allows me to step back, at least for a moment, and reflect on the role of the School of Professional Studies has played on your lives, and whether we as educators have done all we could for you to help you meet your professional goals, your personal goals. It's a big order. SPS seeks to offer theoretical and practical education to prepare our students for their chosen careers. We strive to make our students thought leaders and innovators. We have worked to create some of the highest quality academic programs in the nation, whether high-quality distance learning or traditional on-ground programs. As you leave Northwestern, it's my greatest hope that you see the world differently, that you think differently. You don't accept statements at face value. You question, you evaluate. You use data and facts. You've learned to think critically, to think as a scholar, with an open mind and unflinching desire to find the truth wherever that might take you. These skills now define you. And like your Northwestern degrees, they are something no one can ever take away from you. It is what will always be part of who you are. Today, we honor 612 graduates. 578 have earned graduate degrees, and 34 undergraduate degree students representing 18 different academic programs at CPS. And don't do the math, those numbers add up. I did it already. Many dozens of our graduates are streaming live as they come from 46 states and Puerto Rico, and from 11 different countries as far away as India, South Africa, Qatar, United Arab Emirates, Ecuador, Italy, Thailand, and Australia. To you, our graduates, I offer my most sincere congratulations. A degree from Northwestern University is a significant achievement. It will open doors, get you noticed, and maybe, just maybe, be the difference that will set you on a path that will forever change your life. And at the very least, you will never look at the color purple in the same way again. Only the truly dedicated earn degrees while balancing work, family, and other pursuits. It's tough, and it was a real sacrifice. That's why today is special. Today is a day the world, with all the pomp and purple it can muster, notices what you've accomplished and your many sacrifices. And it's the day to celebrate, and to celebrate you should, because, and please take my word on this, these days simply don't come around very often in a person's life. If you would indulge me, let me share some of our stories here today. There's Tangwa Jarra, who has earned her bachelor undergraduate degree in organizational behavior. Jade first began college 17 years ago and struggled to find the right fit. And because of that, attended a few different colleges, had a few different jobs. It was not until she enrolled in CPS that she found the right fit and a community of peers and faculty that were supportive, compassionate, and pushed her to grow academically and professionally. Jade was so moved by her experience at SPS that she wrote to Northwestern President Morty Shapiro to share a bit of her journey. She was surprised to receive a response from Morty. She shouldn't have been, but it's true, and keeps Morty's response framed on her desk. There's Matthew Merrill, who has earned his Master of Arts in Public Policy Administration. Matthew is an active duty U.S. Army officer specializing in logistics with over 10 years of service that includes multiple deployments to Afghanistan. He completed his MPPA degree at Northwestern via the Army's Advanced Civil Schooling Program while stationed at Fort Jackson, South Carolina. Matthew was able to complete his program in 18 months as a full-time student, all while being selected for promotion to the rank of major, which will be confirmed by the U.S. Senate in May 2020. I was asked to say that, I guess, to be technically correct, so he's not calling himself a major yet. He's a major. He will head next to Fort Leavenworth to attend Command and General Staff College for his intermediate level professional military education. Matthew credits professors at Northwestern for bringing critical real-world experience to class, which he found invaluable. There is Cherie Ram Pulgat, who has earned a degree in information design and strategy, specializing in data science and analytics. The skills Shiram has learned in the information design and strategy program helped him land his dream job in the most cutting-edge technology. He is currently working on building autonomous car technology for Ford Motor Company. And by the way, two generations of the Pulgert family became Northwestern alumni today. Jerome's daughter graduated this morning and they walked at commencement together. And we love that at Northwestern, two people paying tuition at the same time. That was a joke, I swear to God. And finally, there's Robin Cermak, who has earned her BS in organizational behavior. Robin was determined to earn her college degree and so enrolled in Northwestern 36 years after her first attempt at college. I was very taken by what she had to say about our school, noting, she said, quote, SPS and the professors have embraced me as a student. They have challenged me, encouraged me, and provided a learning environment that has exceeded my wildest dreams. Today, 17 of our undergraduates have been inducted to the Alpha Sigma Lambda Honor Society for Outstanding Academics. They are identified by burgundy and gold cords. I ask the Alpha Sigma Lambda graduates to stand and be recognized. Thirteen of our undergraduates are graduating with honors. These students have graduated with Latin honors designations, four who are summa cum laude, high honor, five who are magna cum laude, great honor, and four who are cum laude, honor. Those graduating with honors, please stand. Today we recognize and honor our 29 veteran active military student graduates. They wear red, white, and blue honor cords. Graduates who are veterans, active military, please stand and accept our appreciation of your service and sacrifice. Give a special shout out to Brian Litka, who completed an invitation-owned economics research seminar and will graduate with honors with the economic major. He is the first SPS student in the school's history to win this very competitive economic department honor. So six graduate students are winners of the thesis award. This award signifies a thesis that has been recognized as outstanding among those of the graduating class. The titles of these theses are listed in your program booklet. The graduate students who are thesis award winners, please stand and be recognized. Many of our graduates are continuing to pursue advanced degrees. Graduates have been admitted to doctorate programs at Clemson University, the University of Illinois, Pepperdine University, Lewis University, joint JD PhD program at Indiana University, the MBA program at the Yale School of Management, an assortment of master's programs at Northwestern, and admissions into the medical schools of Duke, Penn State, Wake Forest, University of Illinois, Temple, Terps, Morehouse, and Northwestern. I encourage all of you to remember to look at Northwestern as a resource as you advance in life. SPS continuously develops post-baccalaureate and postgraduate learning experiences designed to provide you, our alumni, with ways to stay nimble and current and to give you a competitive advantage when employers are looking for specific expertise. We offer career services to guide you as you advance in your profession and stay involved as alumni so you can network with other professionals. Whether you continue on with your education now, whether you put your full focus into a professional career armed with new knowledge and skills, or whether you return later for additional education at Northwestern or another great university, you do so as a proud Northwestern graduate. You possess the confidence that comes with being a member of an elite group of alumni. Now we will hear our student keynote speaker, Christina Flowers. Christina has earned an MS degree in information design and strategy. She is an award-winning designer, military veteran, creative leader, and lifelong learner. Christina has shown incredible perseverance in the face of some of life's toughest challenges. Please welcome your 2019 student keynote speaker, Christina Flowers.
Thank you. Okay. 2 years ago, I was at a networking event when someone asked me for my story. I immediately talked through my resume, my client list, and my work experience. But to my surprise, she stood there staring at me blankly and said, "I didn't ask you for your resume, I asked you for your story." And I proceeded to stare at her blankly without an answer. Needless to say, she was unimpressed and walked away. Before that day, I had never been asked such a question, and it was all I thought of for weeks. This simple yet complex question touched a place deep inside of me. A place I had been running away from for many years was a place I was ready to explore. So I started with my childhood. I never had a relationship with my father. My mother divorced him before I was born. Living with my mom, we moved frequently, and I changed schools multiple times a year. During the bad times, we lived in public housing, motels, trailers, homeless shelters, and at one point, our family car. My siblings and I were exposed to domestic violence, drug addiction, alcoholism, abuse, neglect. And some pretty scary people. Sorry. In the good times, I can remember living in nicer places like townhomes or houses, going on nature walks, bike rides, and lying on blankets for hours watching the stars. Though I believe my mom did the best she could given her life circumstances, the good times never lasted long, and this pattern continued throughout my childhood. Going back as far as I can remember, I knew that the life I was living was not the life I wanted, and I was going to do everything I could do to change it. So when I turned 18, I joined the Army, I graduated from college, and I became a graphic designer. But this was just part of my story. How did I get to be where I am today? Who I am today, speaking in front of thousands of people at one of the most prestigious schools in the country. Growing up, I didn't have anyone to guide me in the direction I wanted to go, so I was on my own. I listened to other people's stories, I asked questions, I read a lot, and I worked as hard as I could. I had always loved school, and at times my teachers were my saving grace with a disruptive home life. The more I focused on learning, the more those obstacles that I once encountered became opportunities. My upbringing taught me perseverance, and I have always had a passion for growth and learning. And these traits have threaded through my life as grit. It is scary to do things you have never done before, and it is not easy. But for me, not striving to accomplish my dreams was never an option. There were times I was told that I wasn't going to make it, that I wasn't good enough, and that I was not going to be successful. But my love of problem solving picked me up when I was knocked down, more determined and fueled by the conviction that I was going to make it. Grit. And after every milestone in my life, I am still making it. When I graduated from high school, when I came home from war in Iraq, when I was the first in my family to graduate from college, when I got the call that I was going to be working for the CIA, when I got my offer letter from Deloitte, and every day when I wake up knowing that my children will never experience some of the things that I experienced. And today, we are all making it here together during this most important milestone in our lives. Over the last 3 years, I have learned that no matter what your background is, everyone is worthy of success. That time is our most important resource, and how we spend our time is extremely important. I'm blessed with a husband who has supported me in spending my very limited time pursuing a master's degree. We all have our stories who define who we are in a unique way. And sharing our stories can sometimes change people's perspectives and sometimes people's lives. I will leave you with one of my favorite quotes from someone who had a similar journey of poverty and triumph, Chicago's own Oprah Winfrey. But don't get too excited, I won't be giving everyone in the audience a car. I was once afraid of people saying, "Who does she think she is?" Now I have the courage to say, "This is who I am." The next time someone asks you, "What's your story?" be empowered, be authentic, and think beyond your resume. Thank you.
Thank you for sharing your story with us, Christina. We are inspired by what you've accomplished. We want to congratulate both you and today's graduates for what you've accomplished. That's what gathers us here today. Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Seth Mizell. I am the Associate Dean of Academics here at Northwestern School of Professional Studies. It's my honor and a distinct pleasure to introduce today our alumni keynote speaker, George Casey. George is a 2018 graduate of SPS, where he earned a master's in predictive analytics. He's also a 2011 graduate of Northwestern's Kellogg School of Management and has a prestigious line of Northwestern connections behind him. Currently, George is a partner at RSM, where he is a Microsoft innovation leader and also leads the West Region CRM practice. His experience includes advising clients around the world on supply chain and manufacturing operations, business intelligence and analytics, and CRM system design. George has published in several trade journals and is a frequent speaker at seminars as an expert on business analytics. We invited George to speak today because of his demonstrated commitment, his passion for lifelong learning. While raising three children, he successfully managed to balance an ambitious professional career as well as ambitious academic interests. We hope that his story today serves as an inspiration to you, as well as the three future Wildcats he brought here today. Please join me in welcoming back George Casey.
Thank you, Dean Mizell. Thank you, Dean Gibbons. And thank you to all the faculty and staff for this tremendous honor to speak here today. Today is a day of celebration for not only you, the graduates, but for your families and friends who helped support you in this process. So, while we're on the topic of thanks, having gone through this program myself and seeing firsthand the sacrifices it takes from your family, I think it's a great opportunity for you to thank the people that helped you achieve this milestone today. Graduates, please give a round of applause to recognize those that made their own sacrifices so you could achieve this magnificent goal. Northwestern is represented by many remarkable graduates with which you now join the ranks. Julia Louis-Dreyfus, Zach Brath, Seth Myers, Stephen Colbert, and Anne Margaret, to name a few. I'd like to congratulate the administration on their courage. Instead of selecting someone famous and good-looking for the keynote, they chose to go with a bald IT guy who loves golf, music, and Microsoft Excel, not necessarily in that order. In all seriousness, I'm truly honored to be here today. Last June, I received my Master's of Science in Predictive Analytics, and 8 years ago, earned an MBA from the Kellogg School of Management. After being out of class for 6 months, I was perusing the 2019 course catalog, and I received a letter from Northwestern. I was hoping it was the mythical buy two, get one degree free coupon, but I guess that's still coming. In fact, the letter was an invitation to speak today and alluded to my dedication to lifelong learning. As this is something I hold very dear, I was honored to accept. When presented with this opportunity to speak, I started thinking about what would be appropriate to talk about and impactful to those in attendance. I think, like all of us, my first thought was centered in the wisdom we can collectively learn from 1980s song lyrics. After all, while Gandhi may have said, "Be the change you want to see in the world," it was Journey that said, "Don't stop believing." And it's basically the same sentiment. I think we can all agree that Journey lead singer Steve Perry is our generation's Gandhi. We'll get back to those themes in a bit. But first, I wanted to ask you, the graduates, a few questions. I recently read an article in which Microsoft co-founder and philanthropist Bill Gates assesses the quality of his life and work with four questions. Questions I'd recommend each of you consider as you leave Northwestern and begin the next chapter in your journey of life. One, Did I devote enough time to my family? 2, did I develop new friendships and deepen old ones? 3, did I learn enough new things? And 4, do the people I love me back? Family and relationships are themes Gates frequently comes back to. And I imagine, like me, most of you have struggled with this balance during the course of your studies, adding additional work to plates already overloaded. So I'd like to take this time to thank my family for both the support they showed during my program and for being here to support me today. So Declan, Cameron, and Cadence, to you I say this. Please look up from your phones. Pretend I'm a semi-cool dad. I love you guys. With respect to the idea if you're devoting enough time to your family, I'd like to share a story I heard during my program here at Northwestern and had an impact on me. The story goes like this. There was a software engineer who was also a father with 2 young children at home. The engineer was in the middle of a major version release and was working very long hours. Most days he left before his children were up and got home well after they went to sleep. As you can imagine, this troubled the young father greatly. So one night, he asked his wife to keep the children up till 9 o'clock. This is well past their normal bedtime, but understanding how important this was, his wife agreed. So, true to his word, he was home at 9 o'clock sharp and went right to his kids' room. They read stories, they told jokes, they talked about their days. After just 30 minutes, he tucked them in and kissed them goodnight. As he was leaving their room, his son said, "Dad, can you come home at 9 o'clock every night?" This story illustrates the importance of intention. It wasn't about quantity. It was the intention to spend focused time with his kids in a way that he and they felt was meaningful. Think about your own intention here at Northwestern. You were deliberate about studying, applying yourself, and drinking enough coffee and Red Bull to power a small country. But most of all, you're intentional about seeing the opportunity through. Being deliberate is a great thing. It shows you've put thought behind your actions. If there's a small piece of wisdom to take from the engineer's story, it's to be deliberate in giving your loved ones the things they crave most, your time and attention. When you ask yourself, "Did I devote enough time to my family?" remember the story of the engineer and ask, "Did my family have my attention during my time?" The second question to ask yourself is, "Did I develop new friendships and deepen old ones?" Friendships are a fluid thing. Some come and go, and some will last a lifetime. As we get older and our lives get busier, they become harder to maintain. Like learning a new skill or a workout routine, you have to work at them. It's an active process. To meet new people, you have to try new things and go to new places. And to deepen existing friendships, both parties have to carve out time to make it happen. During my time here, I met some great people. One of them, Chris, is in the audience today and texted me just before I came on stage. One of the challenges of a distance learning program is the lack of face-to-face interaction. Though if you ask Chris, I think he suggested I had a face for long distance learning. We'll never know. For our final capstone project, we chose to analyze golf data and individual golfer statistics in the guise of creating a prescriptive improvement model for golfers on the PGA Tour. This was actually just a ploy so I could use this data and model to be a better fantasy golf player, but that's for another day. We decided we really couldn't tell this story without some live footage of us on a golf course. So my classmate Chris and I traveled to the famous resort course at Coeur d'Alene, Idaho for a round of golf. What makes this course famous, other than the natural beauty of the area, is a floating green that you have to take a boat to. I was lucky enough to land my tee shot on the green and responded with the obligatory "Happy Gilmore, ride the club like a horsey dance," which we captured on video and is still on YouTube today, waiting to go viral. The point of this story is Chris and I were deliberate in creating this opportunity, and I'm eager to continue our friendship for years to come. So, we've covered family and friendships. This brings us to the educational sides of things, third question to ask yourself, did I learn enough new things? One of my first courses in the predictive analytics program was mathematics for modelers. Like many of my classmates, it had been many, many years since I had practiced any type of advanced mathematics. And like most distance learning courses, we exercised classroom participation via online discussion forums, usually in the form of a question that was posed by the professor. In this case, one of the first topics that the professor asked us to discuss was to discuss and describe the first and second fundamental theorems of calculus. I'm proud to say that without the assistance of Google, I was able to answer the question. The first fundamental theorem of calculus is that we don't talk about calculus. The second fundamental theorem of calculus is that we don't talk about calculus. I think I still owe Professor Goldfeder a t-shirt documenting that response. So when you ask yourself if you've learned enough new things, think beyond theories and test scores and equations. Think about your perspective before you enrolled in the professional studies program. Maybe you thought you were too old to go back to school. Or maybe you thought you were the only one that had insecurities and reservations about your capabilities. Hopefully today, sitting here in your caps and gowns, you've learned you weren't alone at all. Mark Twain said, "Never let formal education get in the way of learning." When I was a freshman in college, I got my private pilot's license, and it was described to me as not the end, but the beginning. It was a license to learn. You should think the same way about the degree you're about to get. Even if you're educated and successful, the person sitting across from you possesses skills and experiences that you do not. So in essence, you never stop being a student. Think to yourself, what can I learn from this person? And then think, what can I share with this person to make their day 1% better? Being 1% better means inching a bit closer to your potential. This is described in Harvard Business Review as a philosophy of continuous improvement through the aggregation of marginal gains. At 211 degrees, you just have hot water. 1 degree more, and water boils. 1% daily improvement in anything compounds to 37% over the course of a year. I'm trying to apply the 1% rule in every aspect of my life. Trying to be a better father, leader, data scientist, and of course, golfer. Each morning, I ask myself, what's going to be my 1% today? What can I do to reach my potential? What will your 1% be? And that brings us to the final question Bill Gates asks. Do the people I love me back? When it comes to this question, the word that immediately comes to mind is impact. Impact is defined as having a strong effect on someone or something. So asked a different way, the question becomes, have I had a positive impact on the people that are important to me? My family, friends, colleagues, and community. I'd like to share a small interaction with one of my mentors that made quite an impact on me. It was freshman year of high school, and we had a swimming unit in gym class. The task was for each of us to swim a lap of the pool so we could be grouped into sections based on ability. I swam my lap, and a gentleman I didn't know pulled me to the side of the pool to talk. It turns out he was the coach of the swim team, and he said he saw real potential in my stroke, and he asked if I had ever swam competitively. I told him I hadn't, but he seemed unfazed by this. He invited and encouraged me to join the swim team. This simple act unlocked potential in me I didn't know existed. And I went from being a chubby kid to a four-time letterman and all-state swimmer. Now, one of the first rules of public speaking is you never make yourself the hero of your story. So I hope you recognize who the real hero of this story was and the impact he had on me. This brings us to the notion of potential. A reporter once asked George Bernard Shaw to play the what-if game shortly before he died. He said, "Mr. Shaw, you have visited with some of the most famous people in the world. You've known royalty, world-renowned artists, authors, teachers, and dignitaries. If you could live your life over and be any person you've known or any person in history, who would you choose to be?" Shaw thought about this and replied, I would be the man George Bernard Shaw could have been, but never was. I would have been Tiger Woods. But be the best version of you, because no one can do that better. So, in closing, I compel you to find inspiration in the wisdom of Journey, Pat Benatar, Poison, and Bruce Springsteen. Whether you're a singer in a smoky room, there's not a dime to pay your rent, or a broken hero on a last chance power drive, don't stop believing. Always be working, saving every day. Hit them with your best shot. Work hard to get your fill, and sweat it out on the streets of a runaway American dream. Together we can break this trap, we'll run till we drop, and baby, we'll never go back. Someday, and I don't know when, we're gonna get to that place we really wanna go, and we'll walk in the sun. But until then, keep asking yourselves the questions we talked about today. Because tramps like us, baby, we were born to run. Thank you.
Thank you, George, for your insight and questions and old song lyrics. My name is Peter Kay, and I am the Assistant Dean of Undergraduate and Postbaccalaureate Programs. I'm here today to introduce our graduates. Will the candidates for Bachelor of Philosophy in Communication please come forward? Mary Lou Novak. Anne Marshall. Alexandria Botkin. Sherry Shamby. Will the candidates for the Bachelor of Science in General Studies please come forward? Ramzi Farhan. Mark Jedlicki. Sarah Wood. David Shaw. Jade Tangjai Robe. Jeremy Michael Douglas Yeager. Ashley Knudsen. Harry Schaefer. Elva Rojo. Robin Ray Vanderskow Zarmick. Michael Butler. Mitzi Reyes. Edith Sellinger. Jessica Anaya Agosto. Amanda Orman. Benjamin Keene. Connor Montgomery. We will now honor the graduates of our master's degree programs. Will the candidates for the Master of Fine Arts in Creative Writing please come forward? Joshua Bonsack. Molly Tyler. Will the candidates for the Master of Arts in Creative Writing please come forward? Christine Marie Nielsen. Will the candidates for the Master of Arts in Literature please come forward? Brooke Kennedy. Carol Zalnay. Cheryl May Boyle. Will the candidates for the Master of Arts in Sports Administration please come forward? Oh, excuse me. Before that, the Master of Arts in Liberal Studies. Caroline Schuppe. And now the candidates for the Master of Arts in Sports Administration. Megan Dinoy. Abby Ramirez. Daniel Sagerman. Jesus Reyes Jr. Kim Collins. Ethan Tate. Joe McNeely. Daryl Ingram. Alondo Massey. Danielle Isaki. Abigail Nevins. Samuel Schlechter. Corey Kramer. Sam Starks. Skylar Street. David Heights. Ariel Conajo. Daniel Kubiak. Zachary Jones. Sean Dreyer. Guillermo Zamarno. Will the candidates for the Master of Science in Medical Informatics please come forward? Hiba Ali. And now for the Master of Science in Health Informatics, Rosemary Brown Buchanan. Sana Khan. Anam Ghaznavi. Ife Dolapo Olanrewa Joe. Aaron Kerrigan. Carol Kiswani. Sheila Suresh. Megan Ragland. Yana Imberg. Daniel Roshevsky. Vaidya Patel. Arbab Amin. Huzaife Seal. Soban Shah. Raj Srinivasan. Will the candidates for the Master of Arts in Public Policy and Administration please come forward? Taylor Carroll. Eric Fazzi. Carolina Romanli. Izzat Nasoli. Ross Fela. Anthony Robinson. Abigail Frimpon. Laras Anagonu. Jack Sullivan. Jasmine Nixon. Stephanie Maris. Brian Rollison. Sarah Katsandonis. Hannah Lipman. Allison Knox. Bryant Joaquim Jackson Green. Peter Edwards. Abigail Larson. Elizabeth Cook. Mary Harold. Angel Needham Giles. Kendall Roszewski. Seema Sarani Rematula. Matthew Mayer. Agneska Anna Makzuga. Victoria Villapando. Kristen McCormick. Allison Muller. Louise Packard. Rachel Udisho. Samantha White. Asia Carr Favors. Nadine Hutter. Abedemi Adibanwa. Jordan Daniel Jackson. Will the candidates for the Master of Science in Global Health please step forward? April Joy Rivers. Elizabeth Williams. Sydney Weiss. Melissa Young. Anthony Tu. Winifred Urabosa Ibuwan. Laura Johnson. Catherine Bean. Georgia Glastris. And now for the candidates of Master of Science in Information Design and Technology. Matthew Allen Grossman. Eugene Mack. Brendan McWeeny. Laura Marsan. Margaret Domka. Jacqueline Slivka. Cheryl Atkins. Robert Pieper. Michael Maielli. Shivani Parikh. Kartik Ramkumar. Sri Ravi Palgat. Bridget Isaiah Samuels. And Christina Flowers.
Hello, everyone. My name is Sue La Kim. I am the Assistant Dean of Graduate Programs. It is with great pleasure that I congratulate all of today's graduates, and I'll be announcing the candidates for degrees in our remaining graduate degree programs. Will the candidates for the Master of Science in Information Systems please come forward? Lamont Ong. Melissa Kaicho. Charlie Chag Chetan. Feig Grive. Sagar Ravi. Elena Suarez. Kimberly Caravantis. Shahryar Qadri. Matthew Urbach. Robert DeJesus. Ali Khan. Quan Trong. Maureen Okoli. Martin Orellana. Sarah Willard Franz. Terrence Blindauer. Richard J. Young. Benjamin Cohen. Ciro Valdiviso Pareto. Paxton C. Grant, Sr. Louis Mandachak. Kimberly Snyderwine. John H. Suddeth. Davis Vickers. Juan Sotelo. Rajiv Ravishankar. Thames McTighe. Leah Bowman. Priyanka Hitesh Kumar Patel. Alexandra Prodromos. Stephen Tite Apo. Nicholas Poole. Alan Chuang. Will the candidates for the Master of Science in Regulatory Compliance please come forward? Ranjana Mehta. Matthew Chan. Edwin Rodriguez. Wakila Cheatham. Lauren Weller. Lauren Besler. Rachel Walsh. Natalia Fornell. Danielle Badgley. Sarah Sanchez. Tanisha Burns. Dwayne J. Green. Jennifer Fleets. Mallory Amanda Snyder. Keena Patel. Mansi Mordaya. Will the candidates for the Master of Science in Quality Assurance and Regulatory Science please come forward? Ashley Hui Le. Will the candidates for the Master of Science in Data Science please come forward? Leslie Thomas. John Nelson. Andrew Green. Jacob Weber. Andrew Cooper. Jason Bullock. Katie Fletterer. Amar Khan. Andrew Hale. Daniel Schilke. Charles Utt. Alejandro Garcia de Paredes. Mimi Van Train. Ryan Ruiz. Braden Schrage. Anna Gleboff. Christopher Cook. Muthukumar A. Palani. Jeffrey Grobart. Omar Umad. Annie Tran. Lisa Kalita Lindquist. Isha Shukla. Gautri Kaluri. Alex Schrader. Isaac Gluck. Scott Burley. David Sewell. Julian Chang. Cheryl Ma. Robert Allen Gunther. Scott Morgan. Panesh Roy. Doris Mockler. Gurjeet Singh. Jordan Totten. Tony Hyde. Ryan Burnett. Kanaka Venkata Hema Gadam. Mike Kellner. Alisagar Tanwala. Hillary Mahoney. Devdeep Banerjee. Demetra Constantine. Paul Schatz. Yung-Gu Andy Kang. Sig Adib. Heng Zhu. Thuy Nguyen. Don Black. Yu Tung Joyce Wong. David Robb. Sean Farshi. Kyle Nichols. Nicholas Lockman. Andrew Sushik. Araceli Martinez. Eric Mejia. Andrea Solana. Christopher Shea. Raja Chalasani. Brennan Tucker. Mary Taylor. Agnes Cheng. Belinda Freyna Cabindal. Saranya Vaidyalingam. Megan Rupert. Alyssa Topping. Pauline Chen. Zachary Ergena. Oscar Hernandez. Ajay Nath Jha. Ja. Rupesh Kothari. Rachel Duddle. Will the candidates for the Master of Science in Predictive Analytics please come forward? Allison Hufford. Elizabeth Mack. Paul Barry Seavey. Crystal Mosley. Aline Hilsebeck. Jennifer Novoa. Chelsea Lee Johnson. Nurtaken Savash. Subin Matthew. Marie Walsh. Michael Sapsuk. Zeeshan Latifi. Christopher Ubelis. Rahul Sangol. Suresh Subramanian. Jamie Lawler. Annette Shane. John Lescrenier. Sheila Ham. Oh. Ritu Saxena. John Regan. Dan Ovni. Stephen Hage. Joe Ganancio. Justin Newman. Matthew Thomas. Chandramouli Sharma. Brent Young. Chandra Sekarun. Sheila Maloney. Brooke Wirtz. Bruce Pham. Lakita Hendricks. Wendrin Min. We have one late arrival, Bachelor of General Studies, Brian Litke. Congratulations, all. Thank you.
right, we're almost finished. I swear when I saw this group going out the door, I was thinking, don't they want their degrees? Yes, you did. So I like to joke that today, Convocation Day, is my favorite day of the year because it's the one day no one is mad at me. And that's saying a lot for a dean, I gotta tell you. But let me tell you, the real reason is that this is my favorite day of the year. Today's the day that recognizes a fulfillment of a dream. You pursued something that you've long wanted, and you've achieved it. This is your day. Your family and friends are here to celebrate with you, so please enjoy the moment. So next, vocalist Darlene Kelsey will perform the university alma mater. I invite everyone here to join in the singing of the alma mater, which you can find at the back of your program, I believe on page 31. Following the alma mater, the stage party will lead the recession out. After the stage party, graduates, please follow. Guests, please exit after the graduates process out of the auditorium. Congratulations, class of 2019. Well done.
Thank you. Michael Butler, Mitzi Reyes, Edith Sellinger,